Greetings, hello, and welcome back to some more Law of the Chosen Mortem Edition. And, yeah, so I went ahead and fixed all our mech trooper stats. So, and I found out that actually all mech classes get the same amount of aim, depending on their level, so it's kind of normalized here. They all have 45 will. We have a will PCS here on Heron, so that's why he has 65, or 12 mobility. Mobility PCS here, zero dodge, all kind of normalized. I didn't want to look up the hack value, but that seemed all, it should all be the same. I think it's 60 at that rank, or 65 for the tech sergeant, so, you know, close enough. So yeah, I was actually really surprised that mech snipers do have fairly low aim. That's a little bit disappointing, not gonna lie. And anyway, we're here now, ready to assault a UFO. It's only light activity, which is weird, but I guess we take it. I'm still gonna bring a fairly strong squad here, and I'm very likely gonna boost that so that we can run it in 5 days. And hopefully we get, well, at least one or two more Master Sergeant promotions out of this. It's gonna help us with the whole Hunt the Chosen thing. Deploy. Menace, ready to deploy. Hang on. I didn't put New Haven Advisor in here. Why do you not have your proper sword?
Setting course for Sector 10, Eastern United States.
21 course? Okay. Alright, you get some more training. I think we have Hazmat queued up after this. Okay. What's the time on this? 8 days? Okay. What's this then? Lib 2 with a bad timer. We won't be doing that. A smash and grab with a good timer. Ooh. Strength? Just. I was confused about the. That too, yeah.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
So I was confused why this was showing 10 to 12, and turns out strength is just going up to 3 here. Which means we will have an intel retaliation within the day, I want to say. So we're gonna run the retaliation. Who's here? Whose region is that? Hunter boy. Well, we haven't seen him yet. We've got our Templar here in the Haven as Haven Advisor, so that's going to be helpful. Yeah, and then we can run the smash and grab once we get the people from the retail back. Alright. He's through with his side training, so we can throw Rebecca in. Sure. You know, if Rebecca is side training, then let's do a gene mod training on gene mod on Dietrich's. I won't have someone have some combat rush here. Ooh, I should definitely also have someone for the healing raid because we have 5 people injured. Right, there's my data tab. against the hunter. Not sure about Joe. Definitely wanna have Ion. Oh, great. Great. Yeah, yeah. No, not everything at once.
We've gained some additional intel on the Chosen as a result
yeah,
of our
yeah. Don't care. Don't care. We do that after this.
And together we grow strong. We are ready for more orders, Commander. We only await your choice.
So, Natalie is a bondmate with our Templar. Templar is at the data tab, so she can use Conduit to teleport to him on turn one. If that's going to be useful, she's going to be out of actions then. That's a different question. And I really want to see if transposition works on the Chosen, but I'm still not sure if two Storm Riders is going to be the right answer. I don't think I'm bringing two snipers. So let me just strip you down. Keep the booster jets for now. No, let's stay with AP, get you plating and the other plating. Gotta keep the hit points up. That's not really up though. The hunter sees the whole map. That's so scary. Do we have any other vests that provide more hit points? Answer is no. I'll get back to that. I need to... I'm thinking about it in the back of my head here. Let's actually grab a medkit. I want the mobility, but I'm not too keen on that SMG. Actually, let's do it this way. You make weapons available and take that one. And we're going to build a second one of those. And let's build a Gauss cannon for you. Palm and Shredder Rocket, please. And you know what? You're also not really flush on health, so maybe let's give you a superior conditioning. Wonderful. Strip those upgrades. Take the other cannon. Strip upgrades again. And then take that cannon. Here's a question. What's it called? Plated bit or whatever the upgraded bit is? Wonder how expensive that is. I'm fairly certain the only ability that benefits from that is Bombard. And I don't think that's worth it then. Might give you some hacking score. So you're not coming. I need actually Reaper. I did already. Let me just strip upgrades here. I bought the Tesla lens for you. So I initially thought I'd take him to the UFO. Didn't quite turn out, but so all good. Magazine, get the, I guess, the good laser sight, even though it's not gonna help against the Hunter boy. Now, we did have the speed loader on this, but he does now have the nimble hands thing. And the head triggers are not gonna do anything either. Maybe. So, probably you. Because stasis is good, face walk, this is all kind of nice to see in action. What are the alternatives? Second sniper. Second mech assault. Second person with rockets. Circuit breaker. So do we get an upgraded rocket launcher and get some better rockets for you still? Also, was there anything I wanted to get here? Not amazing. I guess Rupture is not bad. Bandolier is, I guess, is good. Free ammo slot, don't mind if I do. Our PCS is giving you 31 will, so without it you'll be at 33, which is really low, but I also really would like to give you a health PCS. You know, for this mission, one shredder rocket, one regular rocket will have to do, and you get a nanoscale. Oh, I hadn't added anything here yet. Okay. Let's do this then. I mean, a lot of it on Intel retaliations always depends on the map, right? How far away are you from your buddies there? And what kind of other groups you spot. Holy sleep. Okay. Sure game, if we call it that. Bear a bit away. Definitely gonna do that. I didn't bring anyone. I don't think my dragoons or specialists are ready or available anyway.
The enemy should fear us.
Let's get max actions so we can run up and scout.
I can dig that. Sounds like a plan.
Watching absolutely nothing. There's something over there.
Orders confirmed, on the move.
Physical exertion outweighed.
Now, what I should be checking, actually, is this side to the left here. You just need to run, because I need your rocket against the hunter.
Orders confirmed.
My civilians here. That's not the best activation we ever had. Hey, refocus. Yeah, I mean, sure, that guy's on Overwatch, but question is for how long? Up there, we can see him. I only have those three left, right? Yeah, okay. With the additional ability from that, you can reach the armored trooper. Let's have a grapple here. A 100% shot. Well, that's far from being a guaranteed kill, so I think we take the disable.
I'll make it clean.
Hopefully that tree protects me from any flank shots from the heavy grenadier. You gonna enrage? Go and mutilate that guy. Five to 16 damage. Can't wait for plasma level swords. I need some what they called Archon corpses.
Hmm.
That gore value continues to disappoint.
I get it, okay?
Alright. Unless we get something over here. I think I'll do the good old abandoned ship tactic. Just completely leave behind the thing there. Now, I have Fortress. I don't have Bastion, so I could move here and entice that guy to throw a fire grenade, and then it only burns Chet, not myself. I don't think that's the best option. You have... No, don't heavies have ever vigilant or something that they... Am I getting completely confused now? You have salvo. Probably getting confused here about perk trees. Everybody abandon the thing. Like, I want to save it, but I want to save the rebels more.
Wish me luck.
And if nobody's there,
I got your back.
He does have a vigilant. I'm so blind sometimes.
Tracker with an unnatural ability to call his shots.
Right on schedule. I appreciate.
We'll take a look at your abilities in a second, yeah. You have the unnatural ability to position yourself next to a gas tank. Fantastic.
This thing is only going to make trouble for us until we deal with it.
Need to find some new cover.
He did find the flank shots. Great, great, great.
I was hoping I'd at least get a laugh out of this. You probably don't think of the Elders as merciful. But just consider the alternative. They didn't have to build those cities or the clinics.
My friend, dear Hunter.
Fire grenade here.
Combat readiness, huh? Okay. Just wondering already how I get more actions to him. Should give Milan a side. Okay, so he's sitting there like an idiot with 69 health. Nice. Okay, so he has tracking shot. So he can shoot everything that he sees, and he sees the whole map. Lightning hands, fire pistol, flashbang, pistol shot disable your weapon, infighter, immunities. I think he's also immune to blind. Ready for anything, yes. 50% more damage, less damage from dashing melee attacks. Quick draw. Two dodge. Further away I am. Okay. Overkill, Hunter's Instincts. Mummy weapon attacks. Poison enemies. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. Cool, cool. Tight. So I can hit them with my rifle. That's actually not bad damage. 9 to 15. Because of Blood Trail and because he's vulnerable to Reapers, and that will make him move. Maybe, maybe. How do I kill this? How do I kill that? Okay, you can't get high ground line of sight on the mech. You can go here though. Or you could just, you know, rocket this. First one, there was no second row and no ever vigilant icon last turn. I swear. Oh, Slip Rain. Slip Rain ends the turn. 5 to 8 damage. I mean, that's kinda. It's like a slightly improved Soulfire, at least from the damage. Hit 59%. What? Oh, is this awful or what? How bad is this ability?
Fire in the hole!
It's getting a little ugly around here.
And I need you and your Shredder Rocket up in here, up in here. Your range on this thing. Hmm. So you're telling me if I move, get generous rocket targeting here. Through the window, through the wall, through the door, please, maybe? No? Okay, we're not hitting him. Holy shit, you're one health. Okay, take that kill.
Hostile terminated.
And you're gonna be hiding here from the hunter.
On the move.
Yeah, and I'll take the damage here. I'll take the damage over the crippling strike.
Double or nothing.
Well, I don't think that improved my rocket odds. No. Okay. Could throw, just throw another grenade at him. I think he's resistant to grenades, but at least it removed the last point of his armor.
Hey, you!
Not quite reach him.
Our faith will prevail.
I could do that. It feels like really low damage somehow.
Moving on, boss. Grenade thrown!
Is that the best you can do?
I think I need the focus for something else. So it's just one for all here. Still have a bunch of other enemies on the map. Possibly out here, probably behind here somewhere. Maybe on this side, I don't know.
Show no mercy.
You might as well start throwing rocks.
I don't think he has the I'm gonna hit you anyway skill yet.
Copy that.
So that at least should have some effect here on the hit chances.
I better pick up the
pace. Yeah, that's my turn. Not quite. We had one group here. Kinda don't think we have another group there, so that's swap. Shooting the device as your only action.
This is my specialty.
Not quite your only action, but yeah. Okay, so he's on Overwatch now. Probably need to go here, and then I can rock it. Gotcha does not really understand how the Hunter Overwatch works. Keep telling her that. Now then, shall we play?
Jenny's gonna have a hard time with this.
Yes, it only did one damage, but from now on, everything does 30% more damage. Recent, huh? Did I for some reason Tempest Gauntlets? Those are the upgraded gauntlets. Why is that doing so little damage? Oh, it's half damage because dashing melee attack. Right. I know how this game works.
So you're here.
Active 5, okay. Vanguard. Mech. It's not really what I was hoping for here. You can get a running gun flank shot on the Vanguard.
stick and move. Position confirmed.
That was more damage than I thought I could do with that shot. Taking it. I don't think you can do anything super useful here. You are too far away to also do anything.
On it, squad leader.
I was hoping you could maybe get the get that dude over there. Do I have any way to remove that poison? I wish sometimes rebels would start with a medkit. Still need to check that whole transposition thing with the chosen if that works. I don't think I'm gonna take overdrive here, but I'll bombard this little corner and see what the chosen does. Buggers off. Wonderful. But that gives me line of sight on that guy. Don't like that position at all. Let's protect that flank. Heavy mech.
Perfect hit.
Between the eyes.
I get it.
You're on the one. You come in there. All right. We're gonna. Stun strike that guy. And then I can run for all. That should also take care of the poison tick.
All set.
Luke's fall over there.
Yes. I guess it'll give you some protection.
Taking a defensive position there.
Get to cover!
Lots of hunkering. Got one more smoke.
Steady.
The questionable grapple. Alright, Mutant Harrier Captain, double elite. Alright, that's a problem. Have any field medic here, so all the poison is actual poison damage. You could transposition a VT and then fire the napalm rocket back there. That takes care of that problem. Guess we don't get to test out the whether or not it works on the Hunter. I think that's probably worth it still.
Roger that.
Let's run that Overwatch.
That all you got?
Something must be off.
Definitely a lack of support on my side here. Yeah, I think we do that. Let's transposition. Beautiful. Everything burning. Like to see that. And another one. No, maybe. No, that rocket, I can't target it like the previous one from exact the same spot. Alright, we have a Hunter that still needs to be dealt with. Here's a question. Can you see anything? No? That's good.
Digging in.
Can you reach anything? No. So what else needs to be dealt with? The mech, this guy. I think it's getting on my nerves. I'm here to play with the boys.
Sure.
So we can do that. Let me try some fire. Now I'm really tempted to go in there for a ionic storm. Well, that targeting seems to be really wonky. I guess I can give you.
See? You can do it.
I give you my strength. How is it not hitting that bloody muton outside? Are you telling me Ionic Storm cannot. Not hit. It's a storm. It's coming from above. How do I care that he has cover there? It's like, no. Can't do that through the cover. What a pitiful ability for a Master Sergeant rank. Holy crap. Or more like just crap, not even holy. Can you move? You can move. Yeah, let's get you out of there. Yeah, I might still have to stun strike one of. Well, no. I can only void conduit with the Lancer. Yeah, we're not killing this guy today. Well, just not yet. Okay. Who else?
What's the story?
Move you to some full cover. Shoot that mech.
Well, that just happened.
My feet are getting cramped anyway, sir.
This is starting to become a little bit concerning that we can't kill this mech this time. Especially
okay,
if
now I'm angry.
Mr. Cramped Feet here can't even hit that thing.
The death of an old mask
shall be a treasure-forming sacrifice.
Okay. I conned this guy. Yeah, you're like a little bit far away.
Moving into position.
Also gonna have reinforcements fairly soon. That's my turn, okay. One for four, that's not terrible. Still 21, that still requires some extra damage here. I'm very much concerned about Sparna, and
right on the mark. Is it worth living with a wound like that?
That was so sold on, okay.
Time is running out, Commander.
So we need to finish the map right now, this turn. Or this rebel here dies. Unless I can somehow cleanse that poison, which I don't think I can. This guy.
I don't get wounded often, but when I do, it makes me angry.
Yeah, I can probably, he's somewhere here, I think. I can move here and kill him. But you also have a shredder gun to kill a killer. Kill these guys.
I'll comply for now. Recalculating trajectories.
What? I'm probably infighter. Shots here. But that's a flank. Oh, I could have just done takedown. Okay, so can we save our rebel before she
not bad, Commander.
Dies from poison?
Tactical retreat.
59 Isoderm, so it's a tier 3, yeah.
Excellent work, Commander. We may not have put them down for good, but at the very least, we've held off the Chosen for another day.
Let's go there.
Obviously, we also need to pick up the loot. That's even more important. Might reach the flank. You could... you know, it's all about your health. Gotta do something for it.
To fight is admirable, but in this case, pointless.
You go for that guy. I need concentration. Now, Mutant, I'm fairly certain they have counterattack. I don't think it works if they're on fire, but I'm not in a mood for testing right now.
We should gather these. Try them in true sacrifice.
It's all gonna come down to the Frost Mutant Elite and me being too so cheap and just having the ballistic SMG on Jet. Possibly. I got not a good shot.
Just never get used to that. Give him some pepper.
Yeah, I still have one rebel here. I can get a point blank flank.
Fine.
Enough?
Okay, one dude.
Launching an assault there.
69. I mean, that's nice and all, but it's not nice enough. How is that such a bad shot? Holy crap. Just because you have 20 defense. Might just be a grenade then. You are a little bit far away, huh? You are too far away. Much longer. Okay, you're gonna be burning, so you're not gonna be killing anyone. At least. Well, your survival kills my poisoned rebel. This is doing 4 to 8, this is doing 4 to 9. Okay, got the panic. Well, I'm very sorry, whoever that rebel was. I did what I could. Maybe he takes enough fire damage here. He's not gonna burn for 6. He burns exactly for 1, okay.
You might burn yourself.
Down. Help me.
Yeah, reinforcements are coming in.
Anytime you're ready.
Yeah, let's get some overwatches in.
I'm on the move.
I guess at least it gives me the chance now to pick up those. To drop there. But yeah, that was a
inspection time.
Much more rough than I expected it to be. Again, we also haven't fought the hunter yet on this campaign.
Surely there's a more difficult task available.
May I have a quick loot pick up here, please?
Our destiny awaits. That will serve me well.
I think we must have gotten like at least 4 Illyrium cores from this mission. Maybe 5? So.
Keeping a lookout on this bot.
Covering sector.
Readying weapon.
Forward stance initiated.
Oh, you guys are so screwed. Well, maybe not. That's actually the best spot for you to drop in.
Guard. Die already!
Just like the simulator.
Are you gonna die there, Mr. Pathfinder? Longbow needs dealing with.
Moving to fire position. Moving out. I'm all right. Enemy down.
I want you to jump down here, and then you're out of blue moves, okay.
I'm compelled to agree.
I was hoping I could like jump down, move through the door and open it this way.
Confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Okay, we lost one rebel. Acceptable. We got 3 people wounded. That's not so acceptable. Especially since I don't think I had anyone available. Andy's going for the UFO. Fairly certain that
we must never
both my dragoons are injured, I think.
The victory today is a minor footnote in history. A small bump.
This just goes to show that the Chosen are vulnerable and we can take them down. We just have to figure out how to keep them down.
Right, now this is an interesting question. So, I put the mark here on Death Dealer because double critical damage while in shadow. That probably then means then probably need impersonal edge. Well, yeah, that's the thing, right? I just thought critical hits will deal double critical damage, but only in shadow. And again, if you can combine it with death from above, you can, and with first strike, killing shots don't reveal me. I've just heard a lot of people say that this banish is really, really good now. So there was a bug with banish where, you know, the first shot got minus 15, the second shot actually got minus 15, and then again minus 15 twice, so minus 45. So it was stacking up the negative aim much quicker. That was fixed, and ever since then it's been really a target deletion device. And it only has a two-turn cooldown, which is not mentioned anywhere. It's like cyclic fire on crack a little bit. Nah, you know, I'll stick with my initial plan. Right, over here, wrote that multiple people intercept Thingamabob. Wonderful. 20 days, 9 days, 6 days. Oof. So here I wanted to go for Master Blaster. Gain the salve ability. Grenades are not burned to use without ending the turn. And bonus charge on Bombard. Yes. Now, suddenly, maybe the bit upgrade would make sense here. It was 4 cores, a lot of crystals for the chosen, and some assorted gubs. Okay, I think I wanna. Check something. So Natalie is actually available. So I think I kind of want to get Dennis out of here and throw them into bond training. Okay, then before Bradford complains too much.
With the resistance factions has motivated them to share some new information on the chosen.
Necking training. Interesting. Very much tempted to throw this in, if we have a tech sergeant available for that. Then I'm just gonna send again, probably here, the hoplite and whoever was on the previous covert action. Think Danny. Danny certainly was, but I'm surprised he basically has no equipment. You're going on covert action, better pack some rockets.
We'll get the job done. Don't worry, Commander.
Okay. Yeah, so what's the overview on my officers here? You infiltrating, you wounded for 3 more days. And my specialists, well, yeah, one is infiltrating the UFO. And one is wounded for 7 days. I guess we have our support grenadier. Chris is getting some training. I forgot to pack the frost grenade for the UFO. Holy crap. Oh, that's gonna be interesting. That's gonna be very interesting. What a rookie mistake. He actually just... You don't have any disabling shot or anything. I guess we have a stun gun from you. We have a stun gun from you. With quick zap, so it doesn't even get a reaction from that. Quick zap, stun gun, cyclic fire. You know, I think the main difference is gonna be we're probably not gonna be able to kill the Berserker Queen before she escapes, because we didn't pack the Frost Bomb, but we should be fine unless we activate everything at once. Alright, now this smash and grab here. This is a revealed start one. Let me just skip forward like 3 hours. Because then we've got someone with concealment who can scout for us. I definitely want to bring DEFCON on this. I think I'm going to bring you and they'll just kick Mooney out. One of you two. You're still side training. I really want you on more missions though, but oh, let's finish that side training. Let's see. I only want to bring one of those two here. You are 45 XP away from promotion. Jet is 35. Much closer. Get you that Roche nanocannon. Ooh, we probably want to build a... What? Not build. Equip a strike module. Let's see how that all shakes out. Okay. Let's get you a gauss pistol. And then we need to find out how we get this all a little bit more discreet here. Because that's barely above the timer. It's really just there for scouting. I guess if I bring Jet over here, that gets me the 2 hours that I needed. 5 hours actually. Am I okay with having a mech cannon here, or do I grab that Gauss cannon? We have the Gauss cannon, let's actually swap that suppressor with a head trigger, since you do get that automatic overwatch. Right. Let's steal one of those subcorders. Not for you though.
Deployed.
In position to drop.
Right, what else do we need? We need a Haven Advisor in here. I wonder why you lost the Shredder Rocket. I never made rockets available. So you shouldn't have lost it. I kinda want a Haven Advisor here to just make sure that this we're not running into any faceless issues. Alright, let's find us some more missions. Also, I wanna boost this, get this done as soon as possible, the moment it's at 100%. Oh boy. 7 day, 22 hours, fantastic. I don't have people for that though. Now this is not really an important mission. But it's all about XP and leveling up, right? So why don't we boost that, get this to 100% right now? We miss out on 4 intel, right? It costs us 4 intel. Would I pay 4 intel in order to run a mission with these people and get some XP, get a scanning site, get some drops? I think so. That's a small price to pay. Assuming, of course, we win the mission, right? If we lose, we're out 30 intel and a lot of losses. But we should be able to do an extremely light vulnerable mission with a squad of 6. Get our Kimbo leveled up. Maybe our sniper mech. Rocket sniper mech. Alright, let's put a cut in here. When we get back, it's time to sabotage a transmitter and get some people ready to infiltrate a very generous 7.5 day supply rate. Holy crap. I know someone is gonna be like, oh, you're getting all the good timers. All right, yeah, we'll go from there. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.